Okay, so what I'm going to... Okay, I'm David Marteau. I'm working for a company which is named Trellis, which is based in France, and which have for activity GIS hosting. So mainly what I'm going to tell you is a return of experience about hosting QGIS servers and service attached to it with LizMap, which is our product, open source product for web mapping, and QGIS server, which is in fact the backbone of the service provided. We are also QGIS contributor, QGIS core, and QGIS server contributor. So, what do we offer mainly? Mainly, we offer a workflow which is quite simple. We have QGIS desktop and a plugin which called LizMap, which is a. And from then, you elaborate your project to push a project on a server side. We use QGIS server for publishing services like WMS, WFS, and all standard OGC service, which is consumed by the LizMap web client for rendering the map on your browser. Okay, so some numbers. Actually, we are dealing with almost 580 QGIS server instances, 15,000 projects, and so on. I think these numbers, don't focus on these numbers, because what is interesting in these numbers, in particular in the numbers of the QGIS server, is that we are dealing with a large, in fact, this is opportunity to deal with a large use case. We don't control what the people push, strictly. So we have a large variety of kind of projects and use cases associated to them, which they have their own problems. In fact, this is in fact in what we are interested. The problems which are leveraged by the projects, the users or customers' projects. Okay, and problems are interesting because you have to solve problems, and it's always something that can bring new interesting possibilities. So, let's go. So, when you are hosting many servers, you have some problem to solve, which are really standards. You have a scalability problem. You have a distributed architecture issues. You have a monitoring problem to solve. What is the health check of your services? And you have also the security. What you want ideally is the zero conf. You don't want each time you do some change in architecture, you don't want to have to reconfigure everything. So, what's happened with the project or user project? First, projects, they love layers. Really. We have projects that have up to 200 layers in the map. Okay. So, this induce some problem, loading times. Okay, the loading project with many, many layers can take some time, up to several minutes. Okay, you have more issues. Because you're dealing with data, you just pull off the data of database and files, you put that in memory, so you have the memory issues. This, you may have high latency requests. Why? Because a project is talking to may talk to remote services, the database, may also WMS Flux and things like that. And so at the end, you can come by with a stuck server instance. So mainly, if you just take QGIS server, try to put them some on a server and wait at the end of the day, I can guarantee you that we have something like this. Okay, the QGIS servers at the end of the day. So we need for better control of the QGIS servers. For that, we have developed PQGIS server. PQGIS server is in fact a wrapper around the QGIS server API, which is new since QGIS 3. Okay, and from this PQGIS server, we can manage several QGIS instances in sub-process. This will enable in some extent to deal with the scalability, okay? Where we are able to grow our pool of workers or QGIS server or shrink them in order to adapt them to the flux. We deal with the processes health checks, so we are able to control our sub process. We are able to kill them if they don't respond, respond them when needed, and we can also deal with some complex access control lists. Customers usually want a kind of control of what kind of layer they want user want to access and things like that. So we need this kind of thing. Okay, so this is just a scheme of what is a PQGIS server unit. You have an HTTP, a synchronous HTTP endpoint, a dispatcher, which dispatches over the process, the sub-processes, and a process controller, which is going to schedule a little bit the life of those beasts. So the advantage is, it's compact. You have one service, only one. So easy to pop up. You have a simple routing. Okay, you can put a reverse proxy, for example, and have multiple instance units and just load balance between them. Okay, but there is still some downsides. We have still a scalability problem. Okay, I will go that later. Okay, we need a minimal configuration. Okay, don't forget that we have servers that can reach multiple projects from multiple customers. So mainly, if you want to scale for a bunch of users, we have to do some reconfiguration, for example, for more proxy or things like that. So it's not scaling so well. We also have a problem with caching heavy projects. Also, what is caching? Caching the fact that when you have projects, you take the projects, you pull the projects into the memory, and you do a lot of things ensuring that your data are available, your remote services are available, and things like that. When the project is really, really heavy, this is very costly. This is a very big, huge memory footprint and CPU footprint. That's a problem. And actually, what we have is that we have a cache that is, we can load a fixed amount numbers of projects. We cannot load all the 1,000 projects into memory. That's not possible. So we need the cache. We limit the number of projects you have actually in the cache. So if a user is asking for some layers of some project, the project will just pull the project into your memory. But when multiple and many projects are accessed, then you have to evict one project out of the cache. So how do you do that? Basically, there is simple last recently used algorithms that is, okay, this one is the last this one is the last used, so we can not the last used. In fact, the one which the least used, okay, from that is evicted from the cache. And we need also to add more complex routing without resorting to complex tool configuration. You can always do some load balancing or some routing with a proxy. But once you want rules which are just a bit more effective and complex, it's going to be a pain. Okay. Just more about caching projects. As I say, just take 10 projects, you have 8 workers, 10 projects. So at the end, you will have all your 10 projects into your 10 workers. That will be you will have 80 projects into memory. Okay, that's a problem because we'd like to have, it's doing like you do usually with resources on the net is I like to cache, I like to share the resources between my multiple services. But that's not possible with QGIS, okay? Because as we will see, a project, in fact, is not, it's not just a simple resource. It's just a bit more complicated like that. And just as I said, a simple last recently used cache is not so effective. Sometimes you have projects which will be, in the mean, used very a lot. You will have a project which will receive a lot of input at a small amount of time. It will take the priority, and the project which is in mean most used will be evicted. So if it is a big project, it just is going to, you will have to reload it, take several minutes. This will induce latency on your request, and your customer will not be happy. Okay, so things with PQGIS Server, things are a bit nice, but still some room for improvement. Okay, what can we do to make things better? We have several things to consider. First, we have what is going to govern the scalability. So scalability usually is just replicate your service, okay, and load balance between them. It's horizontal scalability. We have seen that projects are not quite the same. We have big projects with a lot of remote resources. We have small projects, very light, that can be loaded and unloaded very efficiently and accessed very quickly. So scalability here is not only just replicated, because if you replicate something that's not perfect, you also replicate the issues. Okay, so you have some questions to the, okay, what is the expected request height? So this is very classical questions. How requests distribute on project? So, in fact, all my projects are requested, which is some projects will be heavily requested, other less, much less. Caching, LRU caching for this is not perfect because it does not take account for burst of access, for example. And how many different projects I have to handle. You cannot put that all in memory, so you have to deal with some compromise or the strategy of how your services are going to access your project. Okay, so this is the overall picture, but which has the direct impact on request processing is how many layers on my project, the data volumetry, and the access to the external resource, which is important and which is a per project problem. So, what the picture that we have at some point is that there is no single strategy. You cannot just pull your services. Okay, this is a good strategy. We have this caching and caching. Just replicate the thing. It does not work. So this is, the idea is said, okay, a project is not a resource. This was the basic idea which when QGIS Server has been created, it was just, okay, this is a resource, we load it, we unload it as any HTML page or anything. In fact, this is not a resource. It's not something a bit more complicated. It's more like an application. In fact, you have to envision your project as an application that you deliver to the user. Okay, so that means that QGIS Server is an application server. You need more control with what is published as an application. You say, okay, my project, I want that project online, I don't want that project online, I want to control when I switch, and so on. So you have to give that to your customers. You have to give a way to have a much better control about what they're publishing. But you want also to keep some level of flexibility. A small project can be accessed quickly. You can live with that. You have a simple caching system, And there is no problem to just pull out that, to evict, to remove this project from cache and roll out that because it just takes a few milliseconds. It's not a problem. Remember the response of QGIS server is not compressible. Usually, you cannot go under when you create a tile or something like that. You cannot go under 200 milliseconds, which is the best as much as you can have for processing a request. So if we envision that donc the QGIS project as application and QGIS server as an application service, okay, we have to do something about partitioning. We want to put some, for example, we want to put some process with low response time process some projects in some parts. You want to projects you want to have a strategy on projects which are heavy to load and which takes very much time to load in another part. So you want to route your service. Okay, so this is why we want to redesign a bit our system. I won't go into that. So our new system is based on Google RPC. Google RPC is a protocol which is very interesting. I won't go into detail because it's a bit geeky. And so if you're interested by that, I can go further after that. Mainly, what is it? What it is, a microservice. A microservice, that means instead having just one big box, you pull and we do the thing, you're just going to separate your different parts. That here, for example, we're going to separate the front end HTTP. We're going to separate the worker part in simple service, which is easy to replicate behind that. And we have an administration services, which also a third service, which will be accessed differently. Why? Because the strategy of deploying this and how you are going to manage scalability on this will be totally different. So that's the idea behind microservices. Okay, for example, you can have design routes from a pool of servers here accessing heavy projects, and then you can access here defined routes to smaller projects and adapt the strategy, adapt the cache size, adapt the response time, adapt the timeout of your services, which depending of the projects, of the kind of projects you're going to publish. Okay. Donc, effectively, as I said, we revisit the QGIS server project caching. Okay, we have an API which will give us the full control of the cache of the server. That is, you can in the interface for the user, he will be able to control exactly what is published, know exactly what is in the cache, select what he wants to pull out, select what he wants to get. It's adjustable to the infrastructure. We can have many unit QGIS server, which there also can be splitted in some process, or you can have multi-services unit with a small number of processes inside. Each unit sharing, each unit being involved in a strategy and in a given configuration. And also, we have a dynamic backend configuration that is, we can reconfigure on the fly the system. That is, we can add route without restarting the system. This is the HTTP service. You just address the HTTP service and say, OK, add this route because we just pop up a new service. Add this routing rules for this new service. So what we try to achieve with this is to have something which is cloud-friendly, at least in a better way than the first version. That is, we don't have to configure things. We can remotely reconfigure each service without to intervene directly on the deployment process. Easy to configure, that means we can use the environment, the variable, the configuration files, secrets. So improving the configuration of the service. Easy to scale. Zero constability, that means I can pop up many services without resorting to changing the configuration. For example, if I have some units that I want to, I need to scale just more. If they share the same route, I don't just have to scale them in a very simple way. So easy to deploy. Okay, I will go to this. This is the Docker Compose. I don't know if the people that know Docker, which is a well-known way of deploying services. So this is a full complete stack. Okay. So just the current status. Actually, it's in testing, feature ready, and we have the code which is available on GitHub. Which is published. It's not production ready. It's in testing. It's a work in progress still. We need to make some still to just harden some aspects. Okay. So this is the conclusion. I will stop here because I'm out of time.
Thank you, David. We have time for some questions now.
Hi. There are a few ways to deploy a QGIS server. For example, Nginx, Apache, PyQGIS.
Yes.
And did you make any performance comparison between those ways?
Similar. There is no. If you do an Nginx as a reverse proxy. Okay, it's just a matter of routing. It's not a matter of performance. Because what do you mean by performance?
Which one is faster?
Faster compared to what?
Between those ways of deployment.
Compared to what? To the generation of files, the latency of the request. Because it depends on what the performance. What you call performance? You don't have, this is not the same thing you have to address. Mm-hmm. If you want say performances, for example, as I say, QGIS server, you cannot reduce the time of processing. You will never go producing a tile on a QGIS server. It's 200 milliseconds at best. So you will never go. You don't expect a response which will be under that time. So the problem is elsewhere, in fact. Mm-hmm. Okay, problem is more, how can I reduce the latency of the response compared to the time which is incompressible of the response of the processing itself. If you want something which is really fast, for example, our user have data which are changing a lot. So caching tiles is not an option. If you have data which are not does not evolve, which are very static in some time range, then you can produce tiles. You can lot of tiles. You cache them and you access them directly. That's faster. That's another strategy. So we may use this because there is plugins into servers that can cache tiles and serve tiles. So we can just give some of the, if some projects are linked, or good for that, then we can use the caching, we can produce tiles, we can add we can produce tiles at the service level, and make the things go faster.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you very much. We don't have much. We don't have time for another question. The time is up. But thank you for your talk.
Thank you.